This is a 2007 Toyota RAV4. It has the 3.5 liter V6 engine, 2GRFE. This same engine, the 2GRFE V6 3.5 liter, is found in a wide range of engines from Toyota, Lexus, and even Lotus. You have the Toyota Sienna minivan, SUVs like the Highlander and the RAV4, sedans like the Avalon and the Camry. From Lexus, you have the RX350 and ES350. Lotus has the Evora, also has the Exige V6. So these engines in every vehicle are exactly the same. There is no difference between them. In the details that I'm showing you about this repair apply to every single one of these engines. I noticed that the coolant level was getting a little bit low in this coolant expansion reservoir. So I did a coolant pressure leak test using this attachment that is specific for the RAV4, and I'll give you a link to it in the video description. So immediately with the coolant pressure tester, I found that coolant was dripping down the back of the transmission. And this can only mean one thing. Coolant down the back of the transmission usually means that the coolant is leaking from the coolant neck, which is above the transmission. And I've gained access to it by removing the air filter box. Now, I know that you can't see much here, so I'm going to show you what it looks like on an engine that's already out of the car. Now, I'm going to stress that making this repair does not require taking the engine out of the car. I just want you to be able to see what part I'm talking about. This is the part in question right here. It's the coolant neck, and there are two heater hoses. One of them comes off the coolant neck, the other comes off of a bypass tube. Now, these hoses can leak right here, but this was not the case on this car. On this car that I'm repairing, the leak was coming from right here where the bypass hose attaches to the coolant neck. And right here, there is an O-ring usually, and the O-ring is the suspect that I'm going to have to address in this repair. But to get to it, I'm going to have to remove this coolant neck in order to replace the O-ring. First step is to drain the coolant from the radiator, and the petcock for the radiator is just on the driver's side, and you probably have to remove the engine undercover to get to it. The next step is to drain the remaining coolant from the block, and there's the block drain right there. It's on the back of the engine facing toward the firewall. I've loosened the drain valve with a 10 millimeter socket, and I've attached this hose to drain out the coolant into this empty bottle. And there's not a whole lot that's coming out. This is just to minimize the amount of mess when I take the coolant neck off of the side of the engine. The coolant neck is held on with nuts on two studs on top. Then on the underside, there are a bolt and a stud, or maybe it would be two studs, I'm not sure. Then another stud down here and another bolt over here. So it's going to be impossible to show these to you on the car. I just wanted you to see where they are here on this engine. These are the nuts and bolts of the water neck, and I've pulled it back there to expose the O-ring. There's the O-ring. Here are the nuts and bolts of the water neck, and I've pulled it back to expose the O-ring. It is right there. I'm going to jiggle the water neck back so you can see how it goes on there. There is the O-ring. When we replace the O-ring, we also need to replace the two gaskets, triangular dig gaskets, for the water neck. And I'm using these aftermarket parts. Why? Because my local dealer, Maui Toyota, refuses to sell me any parts out of their stock of consumables. They force me to special order them and pay an extra shipping charge. So Maui Toyota, here's my shout out to you. What a bunch of clowns you are. And by the way, in case you're wondering, Maui Toyota has not sold me one single part in 20 years. Every time I inquire, they give me the same runaround. And every few years, I check again just to see if they've changed their policy. But they never do. Now for the O-ring itself. Out of my metric O-ring set, I have two O-rings that are different by 1 millimeter in diameter. One of them might be a little bit loose. One of them might be a little bit tight. I'm going to go with the one that's tight and stretch it. I put the O-ring on. I wetted it first with some coolant. And then the coolant neck snapped right on very nicely with a very satisfying snap. This leads me to believe that the O-ring was going to be giving a pretty good seal and we're good to go. There are two things that I do when it comes to refilling the coolant system. Number one is that I use this universal filler funnel kit, and I'll include a link to it in the video description. The nice thing is that this filler funnel attaches right onto the adapter for the expansion reservoir for the RAV4. The second thing is I do make use of this purge valve right here, and I'm going to show you how. First, I use 10 millimeter socket to loosen the valve, open it, and this valve is the high point of the system, so any air that's trapped inside the coolant system will rise up to this high point and will come out of the valve. And to monitor the process, I take a clear hose and I put it onto the valve here so I can see what's coming out. So here we go. I've set it up so you can watch and enjoy this process with me. And I've looped that hose back into the funnel just to keep it from flopping around. There's no real need to do that. I know it's going to take more than one bottle. We're going to start on the second bottle. And there it comes. It's starting to come out of the block. You can see the level rising in the tube. At least I hope you can see it. And there, it's risen to a nice steady level. So now I can take this plug and plug the funnel and that this way I can remove it with a minimum of leakage. I've put the air box and filter back on, and the intake tube is back on. And now I'm going to run the engine with this expansion tank open. I'm going to run it until it warms up enough to open the thermostat. And I'm going to watch and see how much air that remains trapped will come out at this point. And I'll be adding coolant all along as I do this. The engine is running, and how will I know when the thermostat has opened? I will know because this hose right here, this radiator hose, will turn hot. Up until the thermostat opens, while the thermostat is closed, this hose remains closed. A word of warning, as you go to check this hose, the radiator hose that's right there, the alternator pulley is right underneath it. And if you're not careful, it'll slice your finger right off. So please, please be careful. That was all there is to it for this repair. And this car is now ready to go join its brethren back in the wild. And thank you for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please add them below.